off the music while we're watching this replay. Alright, so we're watching this game, Alfari versus Nyasu. He helped out the jungle last night. He's pushing or trying to push the jungle cubes. Like, I don't know if he's pushing actually. I don't know anything yet. He started with a corrupting potion, so he should be playing aggressive. Like, I have a Dawn's Blade, which means he wanna play aggressive, but I don't think he needs to play aggressive early on. He should probably, if he can, waiting for level 3 till playing aggressive is the absolute best with these kind of items. And he wasn't allowed to. He's still in a really terrible trade. He fucked up really hard then. He took so much damage. Yasuo does have the advantage in this lane early on. Yasuo is very, very good. And I played this matchup. I lost the early lane just like he did. Alfari probably doesn't know this matchup very well because you don't get into this matchup very often. It's a rare matchup. And he made a massive mistake level 1, which is completely fine because it can happen. And then he instantly realized, you know what? I'm weaker than Yasuo. I get destroyed. I'm just going to sit back. Use two potions to survive now. It was obviously a huge deal, right? He lost two potions. But the main important thing here is to notice is that he learned from it. Hopefully. Let's see if he learned from it. He's running every single time Yasuo gets to him. He's just running. He's getting out of there. He took the CS and runs. I like that. I think it's great that he realized that he's losing and he learns from it. He just needs to play safe. Keep playing safe. Just do whatever you were doing in fire. You get hit by that. You couldn't really dodge it. You're in a bad spot. It's hard for you to do anything. You're losing a lot of CS. You're actually getting absolutely destroyed in this lane right now. Which sucks. We had that a lot of that have to do with the early game where you fucked up. And that's okay, you know? Because that's knowledge based. That's not really skill based, right? It's knowledge based. He didn't have the knowledge. He didn't know how to play the lane. And he learned. And now he's currently learning how to play the lane while playing it, right? Which is much more difficult to do than if you already know the lane, which the Yasuo player should know, because Jax is picked a lot more than Yasuo is. He lost some more CS. I like that he didn't go for them because he was taking too much damage. Now he's baiting. He might cancel his base. He might go in with it. Both things are honestly fine because if you know Elise is not up here, he could take another wave before the base. Depends how much money he got. Let's see. He got 500 gold. So staying for an extra wave is not going to help him out. It's not going to give him anything. So basing here is the best choice, just because getting another wave is not going to help him. If he would, however, have gotten a better item spike by getting another wave, it would have been better to wait. He's probably going to buy... I'll go for Dawn Shield here, because he's losing. Dawn's Blade is also fine. He goes for Adornis anyways. That's the main item he should go for. Blade is a more aggressive buy, though. I would have gone for the Shield, because I think Shield is way safer, especially than losing. However, Blade is one of the better items with Jax, because Jax gets a lot of attack speed from his passive and 80 damage. Is an insanely good stat on Jax in the early games due to that. I do think right now he can battle the Yasuo. He's behind an item, one dagger, which is a bit of attack speed. But if he stacks up his passive, it's not going to be a big difference. He can fight him, definitely. He also goes for the fight, as you can see. He goes all in so far, what it looks like. Takes a lot of damage, but so does the Yasuo. Both of them are going very low, and Alfari ends up losing. I think the way reason he lost was mainly due to how he utilized his E ability, his stun. He could have utilized that slightly better, and he had to chase around the Yasuo instead of being able to instantly go on him. So that obviously made him take a bit more damage from the Yasuo. But right now he just needs to stand back and survive. Yasuo doesn't have any potions left. Alfari still got his one potion running. He will be roughly even once he levels up in health. He might even be slightly ahead because he got his potion running. We'll see how far that potion takes him. So far, Yasuo is in a bad spot gank-wise. It's very easy to gank the Yasuo, then he's so far up. But Sejuani is not in the strongest position right now. She's not very strong here. And also, Sejuani is a weaker ganker than Elise's, which is on the side of the Yasuo. So Yasuo of all can play more aggressive in this matchup because of all of that. See what he decides to do. He's low on health in Yasuo. He does not want to fight because of that. It's very easy to see. You have less health, don't fight, right? It's pretty standard. He wants to survive and farm because he's been losing these fights. Alright, let's see what he does. He could have waited for one more wave and get 750 gold and Balrog. He wouldn't have 750 gold, he would have less than 750 gold, so what he did was perfect. I like what he did, then he based. So let's see. He's just sitting around, he's not even going for CS, you know? He doesn't need to go for CS, he doesn't need to be greedy, he needs to survive. He might go for a couple because he got the wave, but he's not really trying so hard to go for CS, right? He's always running, he's always being careful. This is a good fight. This would have been a really good fight, but he does not manage to get the stun. He fucked up his jump a little bit. It was a tiny bit, right? If he jumped a little later, he would maybe have gotten the stun off. That could have been a winning fight for him. Now he's level 6, so is Yasuo. He will still be losing. He keeps running. He just played really, really passive. And this looks like a fire thing. Absolutely terrible. Because he's losing, he's getting outrated, he's getting destroyed. But that's all comes down to the level 1. He got a worse base, he got worse items, the level 1 was bad. And I would actually say that Alfari is playing quite good, considering all everything that happened, because he didn't know this matchup. So he's playing quite good, and he learned very well from the matchup. He learned how to fight Yasuo somewhat, and he learned when he can fight Yasuo, which he haven't really been able to do. He haven't had many opportunities to do that. It's been some small misplays here and there, but overall, I think he's been playing well. Obviously, he could have gone more CS, and he could have gotten everything. He could have played better, but considering the level 1, I think he's been playing well. And considering the fact that now we know for 100%, like, he does not know his matchup, or he would not have played this way. Now he gets a nice kill on Yasuo. Hopefully, he should get a kill on Yasuo. Please kill that Yasuo. Good job. You guys killed Yasuo. Yeah, the Yasuo shouldn't be able to get away from that. It was a really nice gank from Sejuani. Jax is low on health, doesn't have any potions. If he had full health and potions and everything here, he would not necessarily need to base. But since he's low health, he wants to get a base off, so he's going to try and push out. He knows that Yasuo doesn't have teleport, just like he doesn't have teleport himself. So he can push it out safely. Elise is dead. Nobody can touch him. Nobody will be able to kill him up here. And then he's going to get his item. He got a lot of money. Sheen is really good on Jax, but I don't like Sheen into Yasuo because you will most likely proc the Sheen on, what's it called, on his shield. So it's not that beneficial. I would prefer for him to get something else than a Sheen. We'll see what he buys. He does have perfect money for Sheen, but I would probably just wait a little bit base and get that Fate. But there's a high chance he gets Sheen. There's a really high chance he gets it, but I would prefer the Fate. I think Fate is better. We'll see what he does. He's actually waiting for Fate. Sheen could be a good buy. No, I don't think so. Sheen could be a buy that a lot of people think would be a good buy. And that's why I was thinking that, honestly, there's a high chance that he will go for it. He had the money for it. Sheen is strong and everything. But in this matchup, I just think Fates is so much better. It gives him health, gives him the AD, which is nice. And also gives him movement speed then he starts fighting Yasuo, which is really important because Yasuo is super mobile. It's really hard to catch up to him and fight him all the time. So I like the item. I like the item choice. And he did exactly what Outer bought as well. But I wouldn't have been surprised if he did the other choice. Now he goes on the Yasuo because he knows this one is coming. There's no way he will lose this fight. They might not be able to get the kill though, because Yasuo does have his flash. They keep going, they're going all in. Yasuo gets destroyed on the turret. There's nothing to do. And I like that Sejuani rocks Sejuani Huan. I think I said it correct, but I have no idea. But I like that he kept onto his ultimate. That's really nice. You see Alfheim right now just running through creeps. He could have done that slightly better by going into the bush and not taking so much minion damage. But this doesn't matter. It's such a small thing. He could have maybe 100 more health here. And sure, it does matter in the end. It is a small mistake, but it's something that a lot of people just be lazy about and not really play optimally. He's trying to push here. I'm not sure if he wants to push. He doesn't have any potions anymore. He used all his potions on the gank, so maybe that's why he wants to push and get his base off. If that's not the reason, I don't think there's a reason for him to push here, unless he wants to get a base off or if he wants to get vision into the enemy jungle. So we'll be seeing what he looks to do right now. He should let that cannon die. He is letting the cannon die as well. That's well played. He could have done earlier, but it's fine what he did. Now let's see if he actually goes into the jungler bases. Because he needs to do something with this. There's no reason for him to push unless he does something with it. He is channeling a base. He wants to get a base off. He wants to get new items. He got a decent amount of gold of 900. Which can be boots and two attack boot daggers. Oh, he's staying. I do not like this. I legit think this whole thing had been a mistake now. Because of the fact that he doesn't base, this whole thing had been a mistake. Because there's no reason for him to push in that case. He could have froze the lane and made Yasuo lose more creeps than he did. Which means right now, he's in a worse spot than he had to be. But he wanted to base. You could see that. And for some reason, he stopped the base. So, he had a plan. He didn't execute it. And of all the play he did, ended up being a mistake. Because of that. Yeah, it's straight up just a mistake. Now, we need to see what he does. He can't play aggressive in Yasuo because he's weaker in items. He's ahead in levels, but he's weaker in items because he doesn't have the base off. And he's weaker in potions because he doesn't have any potions. And Yasuo is full health and have two potions, which is a small advantage, right? Not that much health in these potions. It's only, see how much it is, 125, so it's 250 extra health. But then you also have the advantage of Jax being 300 health down, which is a massive, right? It's a total of 550 health, so that's a big advantage to have. Jax is pushing in. He's slow pushing this. I like that because now the creeps are closer together. Close to the middle of the wave, and then he should shove this in and get his base off that he wants. Maybe the reason he didn't base earlier was because he did not have money for Sheen. Sheen is a big buy, as I said already on deck. Sheen is an item you really like to have, and that could show as the reason why he didn't base earlier. Maybe he'll base now. Unless he dives, he will probably base. I don't think he's going for the dive. Sidra is coming up, so they could be looking for that, but he does go for the base, and I will be expecting a Sheen. Okay, so he's staying now. And this is not because he wants to stay. This is because Sejuani is saying, you know what? I'm coming up here. We're going to go for a play. And I think this whole thing is a mistake. Again, another mistake happening. It's not Alfheim's fault. I think Alfheim is doing the right thing here. Staying because his team is trying to make a play. Adapting to the team. I like that a lot. And Yasuo is being an animal. There's no reason for Yasuo to be this aggressive. He knows they just tried to set up a play on him. Why is he going out there? Why is Yasuo right after seeing that they're trying to make a play on him, going out there, taking the minion wave, he should be expecting Alfari to still be around. He should be knowing this, because else there was no reason for Sejuani to do what she did. And Alfari actually ends up getting a free kill or assist there, which he shouldn't have gotten. He should never gotten that. Alfari is baiting now. So a lot of people won't be doing this bait. He's teleporting instead. He's looking for TP instead. That's really nice. I like that. The main reason behind this entire thing is Alfari have a lot of money. If you look at the money, he got 1,800 gold. That's a lot. Yasuo is dead, but he knows Yasuo have teleport because he's teleports up as well. So he knows he needs to bait here to get equal items to Yasuo or more items and be ahead of him to use the pressure of his advantage. So he starts basing, challenging his base, and meanwhile he's basing, he looks, is there anything happening mid? Is there anything happening bot? Do you have any wards? We have a ward here. Where's he? Yeah, he's tipping here. We have a ward here. And he uses that to try and get behind bottom and see if he can make a play. I'm not sure if this is a good play. No, it was a bad play. He canceled it, and now he's forced to stay top. This was absolutely awful to do, because it didn't work, right? It's absolutely awful. It pushed down really far. But I do like the fact that he tried to do it, right? He tried to do it. It was a really... How'd I say? It was a good try. It didn't work out. Sometimes, you know, you make a good play that doesn't work out. This was a good idea. It was a good idea. It just didn't work out. They saw it too early and they backed off. If they'd seen it a little bit later, it would have worked. And that could have been a double kill into a huge advantage. Maybe winning gameplay, you know. Because getting those two kills on the AD carry is huge. Now he goes bottom to try and get those kills. The main reason behind this is, again, because top is pushed in all the way. Goes bottom, gets the Lulu kill. Really nice play. Gets the... He should get this Karkma play. He doesn't have E up for a while, but he still win this kill. He could have killed the Karkma, but instead he decides to jump away on the Twitch, surviving with almost no health, and then the Twitch go in for the last hit. I'd probably still kill the Karkma and see if I could jump away afterwards. You probably wouldn't be able to do either way. But giving the kill to Twitch is probably more important than even a higher level of play, because Twitch having a kill is more important than Jax having a kill. Jax's job is to split push and win the split push. He's already ahead. He's already going to do that job. So right now, if he can make his team ahead and survive the 4v4, winning the 4v4, whatever, that's good enough. He doesn't need more kills. He doesn't need more advantages. Any more advantage he gets is just taking it away from his team. So if he can give it to his team, it's better for the team. Alright, so let's see what he does. He's going to farm the double drums. I don't like that. I don't think he should. It's better for him just to take the farm, especially on Jax. You don't want to take those double drums. He also decides not to do it. He took a little bit of damage. It was a small mistake. Again, it's not that important. It's just a tiny bit of a mistake. And he canceled it very early, only losing like 100 health or 50 health, something like that. Syndra is dying in the mid lane. That sucks for Syndra. Jax is probably looking at this while farming. Actually, he's not, because he's using all his abilities while farming, so he's not seeing shit. He's looking right now. He's moving down to help his team because he's thinking, you know what? NMC is teaching mid. I need to help him out. Actually, he decides not to. He's probably thinking that his team can defend. But this is the thing, right? He's moving down a bit, looking what's happening. Do they need me? Do they not need me? Making these decisions. And making those decisions is not something you just do like, oh, I'm going to help the team, and then you just go somewhere else. No. You make a decision, you kind of move towards them, then you change the decision, then you move towards them, and change the decision all the time. And that just makes you be closer to the team if you actually make the decision of going to them. Right now, there's a massive team fight in the mid lane. It's nothing he can do because he is in the top lane. He doesn't have teleport. All he needs to do, because he made the decision to be top, he needs to stay top and push this tower down, make them pressure, and do what he can. And just hope his team is alright. His team managed to go 1-for-1, which is nice. Right here, the problem he's having is he doesn't have any vision. He does not have any vision. His team has lost the fight. 1-for-1 is not a huge loss, but they lost it, right? Taking this tower is going to be very difficult for him because he doesn't have vision. So he's probably going to back off, and we see him just running away because it's too risky to go off the tower. It doesn't benefit him enough. He backs off, goes in for the double gums now. He can take him for free. Could also go for the red buff, could also move towards mid, or could bait. Took his item, he does have a lot of money, he's gonna get his 20 spots very, very soon. Probably saving up for that one, which he will have after this camp. And yeah, he just spotted Yasuo as well, so he knows his red buff is down, because else Yasuo wouldn't be doing what he just did. So he's gonna base, get his 20 spots, and he can go bottom or top right now. Both is fine. If he goes top, it's because he wants to focus on getting that dragon, which is nice. And if he goes bottom, it's because he wants to focus on getting the herald. Because he wants to be on the opposite side of the map, because he's teleports up and Yasuo's is not. Alright, let's see. So, he's gonna push it out, obviously. He could activate E to kill these so he doesn't lose that much health. He lost a total of 300 health. I do not like that he didn't use... He should use E and take those creeps a little safer. I think it'll be better for him. He keeps pushing right now. He's just running around. He can very easily kill Yasuo. He's gonna jump him. He messed up his combo. I don't know if you guys noticed, but he messed up the combo. He didn't do it fast enough, and it was all bad, right? He jumps, ready for an auto attack, and then W. But what he does is, during the auto attack, he cancels his auto attack for the W, making everything slower. A small mistake there. He could have gotten another extra hit in on the Yasuo. Yasuo would have been lower. Yasuo actually almost ends up killing the Jax. Let's see if that damage would have helped. It could have been the game-winning play, though, right? So Yasuo is really, really low. He wouldn't have died anyways. It didn't actually have an influence, but regardless, Alphari did mess up the combo a little bit. And that just shows even the best people can mess up those mechanical combos, right? And the better you are on those, the bigger advantage you should get. He's pushing out now top. He's going to go mid to try and help out his team holding. Elise is probably not, he's not low at all. He's going to stay top in that case. The only reason he would ever go mid is if his team needs him, or if he thinks he can get a lot of kills. He's obviously not going to get a lot of kills because Sejuani was dead. And Sejuani doesn't have ultimate, he knows that, because he loses the top lane. So getting kills in mid lane is very hard. So the main reason he would go mid is to help his team out. Right now he's baiting to go bottom to hold the Yasuo who's bot lane. That's what I expect at least, because he needs to be holding Yasuo. He is strong in the Yasuo still. He will win against Yasuo. And it's not a strong thing to hold Yasuo. It's really not. As long as he's 1v1, he will win if he doesn't mess up combos and if he doesn't make mistakes. He's afraid right now. His tower is very low. People are coming in. He's going to be in a bad situation here. He takes the CS, which is very, very greedy. He gets out though. Very greedy to take the CS. He did not need to do it. And it could have been a mistake. Let's see what he does. He's going to stay bottom, I think. He might be looking for a fight here on the Yasuo if Senua can get a nice stun. Let's see what Senua does. He does go in. Senua's trying her best. Jax is going in for the stun. He does make a nice stun just as Yasuo jumps. And Yasuo's going to die here for sure. That was a very nice play. Senua goes down, but they're burning a flash for her, right? And they get 2 kills for 1. It's still nice because they didn't have to use any summoners. Alula flash isn't the biggest thing, but it's still an extra kill, which is very nice. It's a good thing. And now he can pressure while his team is fighting 3v3. He does not need to move. He will probably move anyways just to secure the fight. But he does not need to. And he could just have pushed bottom as well, because he's not going to catch up to the enemies. The only reason he would ever need to move here is if his enemies are chasing opponents and losing the fight, which they should never do, right? If they decide to chase the opponents, they should never lose his fight. And it's better for him to stay bottom. And he does also end up staying bottom, which means he makes the right choice. He's just a bit hesitant if he should help his team or not, if he's thinking that make a mistake or not. And I like that. I like that he's reactive and trying to make plays constantly and trying to move towards his team just in case they make this small mistake or whatever. He'll be there to help him out. Alright, so he pushes bottom. He knows Yasuo was dead. Don't know how, I didn't pay attention enough to Yasuo. If I was top lane, if I was playing right now, I would. But he's going to base. He's not going to go for the tower. That means Yasuo's probably close. Yasuo was close, exactly. I didn't know that because I hadn't paid attention, but that's something you can easily know. And he obviously knew that, deciding his base, because if Yasuo was full away, he would have been going in to hit that tower. Let's look at the items. So he's going for Bram's West. He's against Kog'Maw. Bram's West is really good. He's against Lucian. Bram's West is again really good. He's against Yasuo, where Bram's West isn't that amazing normally, because Yasuo goes for a lot of crit damage. But it's still fine. It's still a decent item, you know? So Reyna's generally better against crit damage, but since there's so many people on the enemy team with a lot of auto attacks and not that many with crit, it's better to go for the Thornmail, which he will probably be going for after he gets his Titanic Hydra. I would assume he goes Titanic next and then goes into Thornmail, which is still a good item. And the Brown's West is just for now, just to have that healing reduction, which is also very strong. His job right now is just to stay bottom. He can even look for the kill on the Yasuo. He should be a lot stronger than Yasuo. He got way more complete items. Yasuo got some shit items, if you look at it. He got Phantom Dancer, which is nice. Then he got this weird Blitzwater Cutlass into an IE, which he doesn't even have finished. So right now, Yasuo can never fight the Jax. Jax will win really hard if he gets into a decent fight, like if he doesn't mess up, right? And you see Alphari does not have any fear against the Yasuo. He goes in on him. He does not fear Yasuo at all. He's trying to make the plays. He's actually losing his fight a little bit, but that's also due to how the fight was going. And then he just goes in and you see how easy Alphari destroys him, right? He went into that fight with 80% health, maybe 75, something like that. And he just absolutely claps Yasuo. And that's what I was talking about, with him winning the fight really hard. And the only reason he was losing early on was because he basically didn't do any damage to Yasuo. He wasn't hitting Yasuo, right? Because in the lead, he can fight this. I don't think he can die to Leech. I don't think he'll die to Leech. Yep, he kills her. It's obviously slightly close, right? He wasn't full health. It was a little close if Leech got some more hits on, whatever. She could potentially have gotten him even lower. She didn't even jump up into air. But she couldn't kill him. He's doing well. He killed 2 people alone, 1v2. Which also frees his team up to do whatever they want, because now they're 4 versus 3 people. There's no way nobody can hold 4 people with this kind of comp. They can't do anything. They don't have any engage. They don't have any cast with these 3 people. They cannot hold it. It's impossible. If Alphari can keep doing this, he's going to win this game alone. Alright, he goes for Titanic. He's TPing in to the Baron pit. just because I think Baron secured. They're gonna try and secure him harder. Yasuo's not here, but he does have teleport. I don't like this Baron that much, honestly. It's very risky. They do seem to end up getting it though. They do end up getting Baron. They do win this fight as well, I assume, because they have Baron. I'm not sure if they win it actually. It's a hard fight to win, right? But they could win it because they have the Baron. They might not necessarily win it. Alfari's coming from the side. He's very low. They win the Baron fight. They could have lost it as well. It could have gone either way. But the Baron gives a slight buff. It was why I thought they were going to win it, because they hadn't actually lost that much health. Twitch is still chasing. This is nice. Alfari's pushing top. He's doing what he can do. There's not really anything else he can do in this. Just push in. People are dead for 15 seconds, but they're deciding to base. I like that. Means they can put on pressure faster. What they could have done is they could have tried to take this turret. They'd probably get it. But the problem by taking this turret is, first of all, they can get killed. That's the chance of it. And they don't want to take the chance. Second of all, even if they take this turret, they waste a lot of time. Now they have to base anyways, and then they'll have pressure a lot later. By doing this, they get bases off earlier, and now they have full pressure and can do whatever they want. He goes bottom, he's just gonna fight this guy. He's just gonna fucking fight this guy. He is so much stronger. He won't be able to catch up to him, so all of this was a bad play because he lost a lot of health, right? Total of 15%, I think, something like that. 500 health, that's a lot of health, honestly. It's a lot of health, especially on Jax, who doesn't really heal that much. He was lucky that he had his Ardent Center Janna down here, just helping him heal up, get back that sweet health. So he's actually not in a bad spot. That's mainly because of Ardent Center's shield, which was really, really nice, obviously. He's pushing down. One thing that I want to highlight here is I think Rock Drake solid. Is extremely good on Jax because
I got to keep my hose fed.
I'm not sure what that said, but wait, I'll read it. I'll read the next in 1 second. I just have to open Streamlabs for my second monitor. So he's just pushing, he's doing the double jumps. I like the fact that he does them because he's not losing any health anymore doing them. Now he's probably gonna look to kill the Yasuo. I think he made one small mistake here. I'll talk about it after. He goes in Yasuo, he plays it well mechanically. Nothing I just saw that was wrong. I liked it. The problem what he did here is I would have liked him to do the double jump slower, keep his stacks up to 8, and then try to have the instant first strike on the Yasuo to do a lot more damage on him. That would have been nice to see because he lost some of the stacks. Oh, I got to keep my host fed. Thank you, Bright. I appreciate it, dude. I just had to check because I can't read it. There we go. So let's see. He should stay bottom. The problem with this fight he just took is that he lost health and he might have to base now. He's walking away. Kog'Maw's here. They're trying to catch him. They're using a lot of people trying to catch him. He's thinking, you know what? I can't get away. I'm going to buy as much time as possible. And he's doing a good job of that. He's buying a lot of time. He's not thinking he'll win this fight. He's just buying as much time as absolutely possible so his team can make use of that time and potentially get 2 towers. I think they'll get 2 towers off this because there's 4 people bottom. They should not be able to hold it. And even if the enemy team decides to go for the inhibitor, they should be losing 2 inhibs. So I don't think that's a viable strategy for them. Let's see what they do. They're not going for the inhibitor. Yasuo is still there. Sinnoh's trying to base. She gets cancelled, but she claps the illusion instead. It does a lot of damage to him at least. Meanwhile, it's the fight over here as well. I think it's fine for them to fight because Yasuo was nowhere near. They knew that, so it's not that bad, terrible. They are getting outplayed in the fight though. Twitch getting flanked from the illusion and taking a lot of damage. They have to run at this point. They know that, and that's fine. Yasuo most likely base because he's not pushing bottom anymore. I don't know if this fight is a win or lose. It seems to be a win. It seems to be very close. Anyways, it can go either way to be honest still. Still got away. Kog'Maw does a lot of damage, but he gets clapped by the Syndra and he ends up dying there. Everybody's gonna die. It's a good fight for Alfari's team, right? They lose. Actually, it's not a good fight. It's just even fight for Alfari's team. And they lose the Baron buff. But they got 2 towers. Alfari's dead. So it's basically 5 kills for 4 kills, but they got 2 towers. How good do you think this is? I think it was okay considering they had Baron buff. They got the 2 towers, which is what they want, but they really need to get the base open. They need to get a 3rd tower. That's where the importance comes in. Open that one. So let's see. Alfari is going to keep pushing bottom. I would like to see him getting the dragon because what we touched upon earlier is that Jax does not have much healing. He doesn't have much regen. The Ocean Drake is going to complement him really well with his split push because it gives him exactly what he needs. He's getting hit on. He's trying to base here. You guys want to see the items? The items is he's going for the Thornmail, as I said. I believe it at least. No reason to go for any other item. Thornmail is insanely good against Kog'Maw. It's insanely good against the Lucian build. It's not that great against the Yasuo, but he's already strong enough to beat Yasuo anyways, and Yasuo is not important at this point. This is a very good item. I want to see them try to get the dragon. I think they're underrating the dragon. They're not even targeting it at all. They're going for some fights. I think this is fine. And we could split push as well. I would prefer split pushing and going for the dragon than trying to chase for the fights. I don't think necessarily either one is terrible because they do win team fights. They do win the split push. They win both. They lost the dragon though. They lost one objective for free, which I don't like. I don't like just losing objective. Going on Yasuo is a nice engage. Very good stun Yasuo. Yasuo next to his stun as well. or his knockup, so that's very good. They're going to win this fight. They can chase them down. There's no way they can lose this fight anymore because they caught one guy for free, and Alfari can't catch this lead very, very easily. He can never jump away from him. He did not need to use that flash, but either way, it's completely fine to do. He just wanted to deny the Mobi boots, which is the reason he did it, because he starts running very fast. I think he could have caught it regardless, but I'm not entirely sure. Maybe it was worth it. Maybe it was worth it. He gets a kill regardless. It's good. He's going to push. Probably could just go mid with the team, I think. Why doesn't he go mid? He should go mid with the team here. He shouldn't be farming anymore. There's no reason to farm the blue. There's no reason to go top because his team is currently winning the game. His team is currently doing everything. He realizes this. He's like, shit, why am I up here? Why am I helping my team push? And he goes down to help his team out, push the towers, and do what he was supposed to do in the beginning, right? It's really hard in the game to make the split decision. So what he did wasn't absolutely terrible, but it could have been a slightest move. I think it should have been the team earlier because he will always be able to get the blue buff on the way out. But he might not necessarily always be able to get the tower and the pressure. And maybe they turn a fight or whatever, right? So it's better to be there from the beginning. Goes for the red buff, getting double buff on Jax. Very, very nice. Red buff is so good on Jax, I think, because it does give him healing, which is what he lacks. Like, I've been talking about this a lot. Jax lacks healing. He doesn't have healing. So Ocean Drakes, red buffs are really good on Jax, and he got that now. The heaven hips are down. What I would expect to see, there's two things that can happen here. Jax goes bottom, just claps Yasuo because he's going to win against Yasuo all the time. Yasuo can't do anything. He just tries to force the tower one. Or he just goes to the Baron and just force a team fight because they will win team fights anyways. He does not need to split push. He can just go in a team fight. Push in the mid wave, go for the Baron, and win the Baron fight. There's those two ways to do it. Elise is currently dead, so they're probably going to rush the Baron. They could do that. If they don't want to rush the Baron, they can just force a fight as well. Either thing works. See what he decides to do. He does look for a fight for the Baron. He does not go for the split push, which I think is completely fine, especially in solo queue, because in solo queue, your team is much more likely to get caught than a competitive game. So grouping is often better than it would be in a competitive game. He does make a really nice catch on the Yasuo. Yasuo's being an animal. There's no reason for him to be there, but Alfari makes the right play, goes in him. He knows his team is there to back him up, and again, they can force the Baron easily. They can catch the Elise, and then maybe they can just go mid in that right now because they just caught a lot of people. They should probably just look for team fight. Catch the Kog'Maw, keep winning. Alfari is going to go up and try to help his team out, but Kog'Maw dies too fast. Just running around chasing kills right now, basically. He's going bottom, which is fine because there's no creeps. The creeps are all the way back here. It's completely fine to go bottom. He's going to have some more pressure by doing this, and he will be able to go for this tower if they can finish. And if they can finish, he'll still be here just in time, so there's no problem. They get another kill, then team surrender. It was over. They could most likely finish as well. I think it was a good game. I like the game. What do you guys think about this? Also, I think I talked